burning hell. Dynamite. The dynamite.
All that came from this robot was a large deflated rubber ball. I had no idea what it was, but Heather fitted the power up in a matter of minutes. It wasn't perfect, but she made it work. Heather explained that by tapping the up button twice, then pressing the run button, I would be able to inflate a large helium balloon. I would then be able to float upwards for a short period of time.
Thank you.
The old lady took the circuitry from me when I got back. While I was gone, Mr. Deck had tried to escape, so Mr. Logan was now literally holding his chain, just like the dog. The blind man had finished up the wiring, so we went to the roof to attach the satellite and prepare for broadcasting the nice virus. When we got down from the roof, everyone was really happy with how the satellite dishes were going, except Mr. Deck. When Mr. Preston laughed and told him to cheer up, he went into a rage, shouting, "I hope this all goes horribly wrong, I will double-cross you all at the earliest opportunity." "All right, Deck," said Mr. Silton, "back to the dog bed with you." "Japan calling, this is Japan calling," came the voice again as the screen crackled into life. Heather leapt across the room. "This is Nighthawk," she said, "we're receiving you, what happened, over?" "Dr. Hero sounded so happy to speak to us. He explained that they were forced deeper into their bunker. He said they had lost many good people, but managed to fight off the robots." "Well," said the old lady, "we're nearly halfway there. As long as we get the last few bits we need, we should be able to broadcast the nice virus in a matter of weeks." "Do not worry," said Dr. Hero. "We will survive." We'll be right back. Even Heather was confused by this upgrade. It took her ages, but with a few final twists of her spanner, the power-up was complete. Once we got it working, it was great. I could finally walk along while ducking. I knew the score, 10 minutes to get back to the hallway.
Thank you.
Sim took the satellite part from me and promptly dropped it. The old lady looked worried as she picked it up. Achoo! But luckily it was still in working order. So we made our way up to the roof to install it. With this, we were one step closer to broadcasting the nice virus.